Yeah, because beloved, what we're doing is there's so many beloveds that don't get any evangelistic teachings anymore. And we're trying to get the evangelistic stream growing, because to us, it's not a denomination, beloved. To us, it's Christ. Christ, the power and the wisdom of God. And that has to flow. We have to find and keep the path alive which leads to God. And that's our main objective, isn't it? You know, a lot of people say, no, are you breaking away from the old apostolic church or breaking away? You can never, you know, if you ask when Abram became Isaac or David, did Abram break away from David, or David break away from Abram? No, he didn't, because it evolves. The spirit evolves, the wisdom evolves, because from Jesus, from Adam to Jesus, the first Adam was of the earth, the second Adam is the Lord from heaven. So that spirit has to evolve all the time. And now we have to keep Christ alive, beloved. There's not, and please, I'm not against any religion or any dogma or anything, but the spirit Christ, beloved, the wisdom, as I said, and the power of God, the path which leads to God, that can't be stopped. Because if that stops, we can have 100 churches, but when the path, the spirit path that leads to God, the method of how to get to God and enter into the kingdom of God, when that stops, beloved, then there's a problem on the planet. Because it happened before. And God asked us to continue this, to just keep the path going which leads to God. Because there's so many things going on in so many different communities, and the people, that they, no gifts can be laid out, and et cetera, et cetera. So we don't want that to stop. It's not against anybody, as I said. It's just to keep the spirit alive for us to know how to enter into the kingdom of God. Because I said a million times before, beloved, your priest or your overplace cannot send you into the rest. It's impossible. You need this gate. Because the kingdom of God is within me. I just want to repeat this, beloveds, for those, I know those of many of you are tired of this already, but for those who don't know, even at the sealing service, the apostle needs physical overseer and the wife with physical bodies for the spirits to enter into the kingdom of God. So when you leave your body, it's too late, because then you didn't use your body, beloveds. So when you're in the kingdom of God, your overplace have to get you into the kingdom of God. Because when you leave the body, you're in the kingdom of God already. Otherwise, you're going to return to where you come from. It's as simple as that, which I will explain to you. But our main objective is to enter into the kingdom of God. Because when you leave your body and you didn't enter into the kingdom of God, you're going to return to the astral, the Dodereik. And when you're there, your priest can't send you anywhere. There isn't going to be any little angels coming to pick you up or big pearly gates opening. It's not going to happen. You're going to be disgusted. I promise you that. And you're going to be very angry, because it's not going to happen. You have to enter the kingdom of God while you have this gate. You enter from a spirit world. You are born in this physical body, which is all an illusion. And then you seek the truth and reality, which is God. And by the spiritual teachings of God, you ascend into higher levels of God consciousness, into the heavens. And when you're in those heavens and you leave your body, it's just like shedding a jacket. Then you'll be in the kingdom of God. And then you won't even know what's happening at your funeral, because you'll be with your creator. And you'll be in the heavens. You don't want to be in the astral. You want to be in the kingdom of God. And all these things about you'll be resting in the brother office and the underdeacon office and priest, all those things I'll explain to you. But believe me, nobody can send you into the kingdom of God after you left your body. They can at the apostle service, yes, but that's another story. So, yes, beloveds, I just want us to, are there any questions from anybody? Okay. Beloveds, are you sure? No questions? Can everybody hear me?
Yes.
Okay. Beloveds, I don't know if this is a suitable time. I actually want us to break bread on Mondays and Thursdays and maybe Wednesdays if we don't have a specific topic to break bread about or just to teach. But there's one thing that we have to remember, beloveds. The Bible from Genesis to Revelation is spiritual. Now, beloved, if there's anybody that don't understand that, you have to understand that, because that is the way God gave us the Bible. And I want to start again, beloveds. I know many of the members know these things, but for this to sink in, beloveds, even on your field of testimony, you have to understand that from Genesis 1, nothing is physical. Let me give you an example. In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. And then God said, let there be light. And there was light. Now, when you're on testimony, the field of testimony, you say, now, what light was that? Then they say, no, it's the sun. You say, no, God made the sun on the fourth day only. So there was 4 days without a sun. How is that possible? When we look at Genesis 1, okay, God created the heaven and the earth, and he said, let there be light. And then he separated the waters from the waters. Now, I'm talking physically. If the creation in Genesis was a recording of the physical creation, God separated the waters from the waters, and he placed a firmament between the waters and the waters to separate the waters from the waters. Let's assume it's the sea and the clouds. So he placed a firmament between the waters and the waters to separate the waters from the waters. And he named the firmament heaven. So number one, heaven has to be under the clouds. Number two, then on the fourth day, God made the sun, the greater light to rule over the day, the lesser light to rule over the night, and also the stars. And he placed it in the firmament, beloveds. So if the creation in Genesis was a recording of the physical creation, then the sun, moon, and stars has to be under the clouds. So there in itself, it's a no-go, because it just can't work, can it? So 4 days without a sun, and then he makes the sun and he places it under the clouds inside the firmament. So then, beloved, God created Adam on the sixth day. And then he said to Adam, don't eat of the tree knowledge good and evil. So, because he said, if he eats of the tree knowledge good and evil, he will know what we know. So now it's not an apple tree, because I promise you, beloved, there are beloveds that teaches the beloveds that it was an apple tree. That's how far it's gone astray now. Literally. Now, I don't want to name names and everything, but I promise you, that's how bad it's getting. So what tree can you eat of to know what God knows? How can that be physical, beloveds? And then he ate of the tree. And you know what happened when he ate of the tree? He saw he was naked. So how can you walk around naked but not be aware of it? It's impossible, isn't it? But when you eat of the tree of knowledge, when you know the difference between right and wrong, knowledge, good and evil, that's when you know, but I'm naked. I have a job to do. And then he said, he mustn't now eat of the tree of life, because then he will become like us. He will become immortal. So, beloved, another question. What kind of a tree will give you eternal life? What garden? What place? He made Adam, beloveds, in his image. To God's image, he made them. So now, if God made Adam to his image, what is God's image? Love, the truth, spirit, all spirit, beloved. Why? Where does God live? Within me. What is God? I am love. I am light. I'm the truth. So if God is spirit in the form of light and love and the truth, where else will truth live but within me? Where else will light of understanding be but within me? Where else will love be but within me? So that's how God makes his abode within us. Then Adam found that he was naked, and he covered himself with the fig leaves. What is that, beloved? That's excuses, isn't it? Why? Because he listened to the snake. I explained the snake about two Zooms ago. Exactly, the dragon with a tail. So I'm not going to do that again. You just watch those videos. He said, I can't eat of this tree because I'll die. I'll surely die, says God. And he says, you will surely not die. Now, let's now take it physically, beloveds. If you're busy testifying somebody, you say, is God a liar? Say, why? Did he die after he ate the tree of knowledge? The snake said, no, he's not going to die. And he ate, did he die? No, he didn't die. So now let's take one step back. Show me a snake that can speak. It's impossible, isn't it? But beloved, I just want to be rest assured that Adam did die. Adam did die. That is the fleshly thoughts within us. That is to be earthy. Because the first Adam, according to 1 Corinthians 15, the first Adam was of the earth. The second Adam was the Lord from heaven. So the first Adam is Adam the earthy. And was Adam the son of God, beloveds? Go read Luke 3:38. Adam is the son of God. Jesus is the son of God. So the first Adam is earthy, the second Adam is the Lord from heaven. So now, let's see. Now I'm going back to the discussions. If Adam earth was spiritual, but earthy, and Jesus Christ is the Lord from heaven. So the first Adam is earth, the second is the Lord from heaven, Jesus. Now, I want you to focus, beloveds. This is very important to understand. So they said, no, but first is the earthy, then came the Lord from heaven, which is spiritual. So why do we say, if Adam was earthy, but he was spiritual, he couldn't have been physical, which I'll return to now. But Jesus Christ, which is the second Adam, they say is physical. How do you get that? Now we say, no, but Adam maybe is spiritual, but Jesus is physical. No. How can you say that? Because the first Adam is earthy, the second Adam is the Lord from heaven. So how can he be physical? He must be spiritual, isn't it, beloveds? So these things are very important to understand, beloved. If you don't understand it, please ask. I'll explain it to you in detail. You will never, ever think Jesus was a physical being again. I promise you that. And if you don't know that, beloved, you're going to serve a Christ of flesh. And that is going to prevent you from entering into the kingdom of God, because you're thinking fleshly and flesh is death. Read Romans 8. And spirit is life and light. So, beloveds, these are things we have to understand. Jesus Christ is born in Bethlehem. What does Bethlehem mean, beloved? The house of bread. There where we break bread, Christ will be born within us. And that Jesus Christ is not born a grown-up. It's born a baby. It lives off water and milk. Because he says, I have to feed you with milk because the things of the grown-up you cannot understand. So when we come into the church or we're taken up and we receive the laying up of the hands of a living apostle, we think we're in the kingdom of God. You're not, beloveds. Believe me. To be in the kingdom of God is to conquer the flesh, the fleshly understanding. And that's the flesh the Bible is referring to according to 1 John 4, where he says, those who say that Jesus did not come in the flesh is not of God. How does that work? What flesh did he come in? Not this flesh, beloved. If I leave my body, am I not still in the flesh? Am I not still covered in a fleshly thought, a fleshly mind? Am I not controlled by the senses still? Am I not controlled by the fleshly mind? Yes, beloved. When two people get married, beloved, what do they say? You become one flesh. Why? How does that happen? Do you and your wife become one body? No, you become one of mind. Where I used to do my thing and she used to do her thing, now we get married, we become one of mind, one of thought. And that's the difference. So that's the flesh the Bible is referring to, beloved, because every day you have to die. Paul says, I die daily. And you will have to die daily, isn't it? Pick up your cross daily and follow me. Why? Because I have to conquer the fleshly mind and fleshly understanding. Why? Because flesh and blood cannot enter into the kingdom of God according to 1 Corinthians 15:50. Flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God. So now I have to conquer the flesh. And the soul has to be set free of the mind to ascend into higher levels of God consciousness, closer to God, more spiritual, less fleshly, more light, less darkness, less flesh, more life, more spirit. And that's how we enter into the kingdom of God, beloved. We ascend. Where's God? Above us. How is he above us? He can't be physically above us, but he's a higher level of understanding. We have to ascend into higher levels of knowledge and spiritual wisdom for us to reach that level of understanding. I made an example yesterday as well. When my brother is an example to me and I look up to him, do I physically look up to him? No, beloveds. He's a higher level of understanding. He's highly educated. So he's not higher than me. People move in higher circles. They're not physically higher than us. They're just much wealthier than us, or they're much more educated than us. So they move in higher circles. So that's how God is above us. God is way above our human comprehension, our mind understanding. And that is why he says, no man has ever seen God. Now we think he's referring to this. Again, beloved, get away from that. Nowhere in the Bible is any physical being mentioned, ever. And I'll show that to you. Please, don't give up on this. It's something you have to understand. Because I promise you, your other place is not going to send you into the kingdom of God when you leave the body. You're going to be very angry and very disappointed. So now we have to understand the method of entering into the kingdom of God. And what is that method? Jesus Christ. I am the way, the truth, and the life. Nobody comes to Father but by me. So now, I want to come back. I want to show you man. When you read about in the Bible and you read about man, people think it's this. It's not. Man is Adam, beloved. Everybody that is spiritually enlightened, those who are created in God's image, that is man. But now there's the first man. In John 3, Jesus says to Nicodemus, don't you know that man has to be reborn of water and spirit, and he will enter into the kingdom of God, beloveds? What is that? Can this be reborn? No, but man can, from Adam to the Lord from heaven, and that's how Adam died. He conquered the flesh and his way of understanding until he became the Lord from heaven. Does that make sense, beloveds? So now, I want to go back to the question I asked. He says, no man has ever seen God. So can you now see what I'm referring to? Those who are still in the old commandment, those who are still living after the flesh, we created in God's image, but we haven't seen Christ yet. We don't know God yet. We're still living after the flesh. And that is the problem with Adam. That's why he is natural. We think naturally. So no man has ever seen God. Those who haven't seen God, those who haven't seen Jesus, those who can't see that God is speaking through a mouth. Let me give you an example, beloved. You go read John 14. Jesus is standing with Philip. Philip says to Jesus, where are you going? He says, I'm going to the Father. He says, show us the Father, and it will sufficient us. He says, Philip, you've been with me so long, you haven't known me. If you see me, you will see the Father. If you see spiritually, if you see Christ within me, you will see Father within me, because Father creates through his Son, beloveds. Who's the Son? There's the Son, beloved. Aren't you the Son of God? Whether you be female or male, beloveds, it doesn't matter. You're still male, and the males are still female. When somebody teaches me, I'm female. When I teach somebody else, or a sister teaches me, I'm female. She's male. You are then Christ. You are the Messiah. You must save me. You must enlighten me. Because you are the path which leads to God now. You can teach me how to reach God. And that's how serious it is, beloved. I don't want your mind to wander away about some Jesus that was nailed to a cross. It doesn't exist. The cross is the love of God above all and my neighbor as myself. That's the cross. There's no other cross. And my flesh will be nailed to that cross when I become the Son. And that's how it's been from the beginning. So, beloved, that flesh that God is referring to, no man, the fleshly man, those who think, understand physically, won't see God. And that's why Jesus is standing with Philip. Now, beloved, please don't misunderstand me. There's not a physical Jesus and a physical Philip. There's a person with a gift of Christ within him, and there's another person with a gift of Philip within him. Now, that Philip within me hasn't been evolved far enough to understand God. So he hasn't seen God. That's why the Bible says no man has ever seen God. So when he said, you haven't seen me, Philip, or brother, I'm an overplaced, or I'm the apostle, or I'm a overseer. And I say, but it's the overseer speaking. Remember that, beloved, if the overseer is out of that body, there's nothing. And before the gift God was within him, there was nothing. But when the gift of God was formed within that individual, then he was formed in God's image. And that gift rose and ascended into the overseer office, or the elder office, or the priest office. So it's the priest in the form Jesus Christ speaking to Philip or Goliath or Samson or whatever. These are all spiritual things, beloved. So when Jesus said, you haven't seen me. If you see me, you'll see the Father. He meant that you have to be reborn. You have to be reborn with water and see spiritually the word of God. And you will be transformed into a spiritual way of understanding. And then the eye will open. And then you no more man of this, the earthy one. You become the Lord from heaven. And you will see God because Jesus Christ is Emmanuel, beloveds. What is Emmanuel? God with us. Not Jesus with us. God with us. So if Jesus was physically crucified, they saw him ascend on the clouds physically. Where to? Where did he go? Then God is somewhere there. Because if he was physically crucified, beloved, he had to physically raise from the dead, isn't it? Because he was with his disciples and they said, no, you spirit. He said, so how do you feel? Then you won't be able to feel the wounds in my flesh. Jesus rose in flesh. Let me explain to you. We only have a few minutes left. Let me explain to you, beloved. When I ascend into the underdeacon office or the priest office, I have to conquer flesh first for the spirit to grow within me. And the more spiritual I become, the higher I ascend into a higher heaven. But if I'm in a priest heaven, I still have to conquer flesh to ascend in the elder heaven, isn't it? So I still have flesh, but I have less flesh than the brother and the underdeacon. That's how it should be. So now I have more flesh to conquer, and into the overseer and into the apostle. Less flesh, more spirit. Go read John 3:30. He says, I must decrease and thou must increase. Beloveds, so we have to understand that flesh that has to die, you can never hang on a physical cross. You can hang on the cross of loving God. I love God above everything, and I love my neighbor as myself. Those who do the will of my Father. Isn't that what Jesus said in the temple? Your mother and brothers waiting outside. He said, that's not my mother, my brother. Those who do the will of my Father, those who think like I do, those who are created into God's image, we are one. Spirit can't be one with flesh. Spirit is spirit. Flesh is flesh. And flesh cannot see God. No man has ever seen God. But he that is in the bosom of the Father, not was, he that is in the bosom of the Father, he declared him. So those who become the Son and connected with God, those who ascended into higher levels of God wisdom, that connected to God, they can come down to our level and uplift us. Isn't that what Jesus said? I'm going to my Father, but I'll come back and bring you where I am. Isn't it? What does that mean? When I go to my overplace and he teaches me, I come back and I bring you where I am. What I learned, I teach you, and I bring you up to my level of understanding. This is the God that we serve, beloved. There's no physical God from Genesis to Revelation. I promise you, anything you want to know, we will break bread and you will see it doesn't exist. There never was a physical Jesus. And I'm not arguing with anybody, but for your soul's sake, please do yourself a favor and find out how it works. And if you don't understand, beloved, come to one of these Zooms every night and you ask until you know. Because when you know, you see. When you see, you know, and you can become that. So, beloved, don't let anybody tell you you can't become whole. Let this thought be in you, which is also in Christ Jesus, who thought it not a robbery to be equal with God. John 17, Jesus says to Father when he's praying, he says, Father, I pray not for the world, only those that thou hast given me. For they are thine and thine are mine. I have overcome all the flesh. I have overcome the world. The flesh, man. How do you overcome the flesh? On the cross, beloveds. Because you die, you conquer the mind. and you ascend in a more glorified body, you become more spiritual, more glorified, less pain. Because for as long as you have flesh, you will pain. They will chop you with a sword. They'll throw you with stones. And as long as you have flesh, it will hurt you. But when you become spiritual, beloved, nothing can touch you. When you have God's image, nothing can touch you. Then you're in higher heavens. And when you're in those higher heavens and you conquered the flesh, beloveds, when you leave this body, the body will just fall away and you'll remain in the kingdom of God. But you, if you're in the dwaderek or the astral, you will return where you come from because you're losing your gate. This is a gate that you ascend through. So I know to many of you, beloveds, these are new things. But beloved, these are things you have to know. Now just come to church or just be here 7 days a week. Beloved, you will not. You go to church to ascend. You go to church to conquer flesh, because flesh and blood can't enter into the kingdom of God. That's what you're doing there. That's why you go to church 7 days.